It's not beer goggles for a change, bit of a whiskey watch. Ooh, whiskey watch. I've got a few bottles here and there, and I've got amongst them, I've got these lovely ones. Yum, yum, yum. I've got that one there, quite a nice one as well. Yum, yum, yum. And I've got this one here. This is, I ordered online from Asda's a delivery, and amongst them I've kind of got whiskies that I put in my coffee and porridge and all that, and usually I use White & Mackay, and I ordered that one to you know, I either put sprigs of cinnamon in it and stuff like that as well, you know. I know people are gonna go, what, oh okay, okay, but you know, so I either do that and chuck a little bit in my porridge and things like that, just to spruce it up a bit. Or I'll put a bit of my coffee in it. And also I like a little nip of that on its own, and it's nice, you know. It's cheap and it's kind of lovely for a cheap one, a bit of White & Mackay. So I've ordered that and I've got this down in place of it. I think I ordered a 700. And I've got this, and it was a litre, I think, if I'm not... Is it a litre? Is it, isn't it? Why did I accept this? I can't remember. Because they give you a choice at your door. Do you want to accept it or not? And I looked at it and thought, mm-hmm. Well, you know, I've never heard of it myself, but it got a... what's this thing? World Spirits Challenge. Now, you know, it's a silver one. I know about the World Beer Challenge thing, similar idea. I'm not brilliantly up with you. I'm not sort of your top Johnny and all that with the whiskies and that, but I kind of sensory evaluation and that. But the knowledge of it, all the back stories and everything else, you know, you have to kind of Google it. But sensory evaluation I'm okay with, you know. But... This is blended Scotch whiskey, and it's from Asda's, and it's like specially selected, exclusively for Asda's. And it don't really say a lot else, but it just says McKendricks in it. I don't know whether that's their own made-up name or what, because I've never heard of McKendricks. W. McKendricks. McKendricks. So you tell me about it if you know about it, but I'm not... Personally, I don't really know about it. 3-year-old, it says on there, and that is the minimum age. I'm going to ask you a question here. That's the minimum age of whiskey, 3-year-old. But when you got blended whiskey, can you have 3-year-old malts, 3-year-old grains, things like that? Can you have stuff that's not 3-year-old and then still have blend it in and call it a whiskey? Let me know, guys. Let me know if you know. If you don't know, just say, I don't know. Don't say, oh yes, of course you can, and I'll go, oh yeah, and people go, what do you want about? I do check it out though. Right, so let's get one of me little flames. They always look like jet flames, don't they? And they're designed like that so that the, you know, all the nice little sniffies all go up your bugle. It kind of sends it up that way. And if you hold it around sort of that area, like that, hold it around there, you get all sorts of lovely little aromatics and stuff. Now it says on here, kind of have this one neat with ice. I'm not going to kind of listen to either of those, because if you're putting ice in whiskey, pour it to like near the kind of near the fattest lump, because then you get the larger surface area in it. If you're putting ice in whiskey, you're completely ruining it. There's oils in whiskey. Also, the alcohol is a good carrier of flavours and aromas. That's why it's in perfume. Sorry. Oh, you want to see the bottle as well, didn't you? Like, did I show you? There you go. And let's put it down on the floor there, because I ain't got no room up on me bookshelves. And I've got my little what do you call it here with water in it? I'm gonna have a little spoonful of that, teaspoon. I've got a tablespoon, but I'm just gonna have a tiny little bit, just to separate, maybe less than a teaspoon, just to separate out the let it open up a little bit and all that. And you see it open up sometimes, depends. Sometimes on a good, especially if it's a non-filtered one, you'll see the oil separate out and they'll come to the surface. And also it kind of lets molecules go free and breathe out. Anyway, just have a little swirl that in there. Yeah, it's nice, it's kind of doing its stringy thing that it does, isn't it? Right, let's have a little snifter. It's a weird one. This is, it's not got a bad smell, it's not horrible, and it's got certain pleasantries in that about it. Same as most whiskies. Even your cheap ones, and they've got a pleasantry about them. See, I'd rather have a poor whiskey, right, than an half-decent brandy sometimes, you know. Nice little orangey notes and that, nice little kind of, little grape notes as well, but nice little orangey notes, little tannins and things like that. Little kind of sugar snap biscuit edges on there. Tangerines and things, little lemon pith in there, little lemon pith and zest, but mainly the pith. Little nutty notes, kind of peanuts and peanut husk, those, you know, the monkey nuts when you're breaking them in it, that sort of smell that you get on your fingers in it. Right, well, let's have a little taste of that. Sláinte, everyone. Cheers. Funny enough, on the taste, you're getting tiny little strawberry edges, like dried strawberry. It's not bad. Nice little attack on the tip of the tongue, little zip, little alcohol attack, but it's not, it ain't really got that, yeah, gone, like that. But then again, that's kind of sweet and nice, it's smooth. It's smooth, it's nice, it's very unassuming and that, and it's not really special, but it's not horrible. I'm not sure what you pay for this in Asda's. Sorry, why am I pointing up there? What you pay for that in Asda's, McKendricks. And I imagine it's kind of, you know, down your low price and everything. And if it's low enough, it's worth it, you know. But at low prices, you can get quite often White Mackay, and that's is, you know, it's usually quite cheap anyway. You know, it's usually one of the cheapest, and that's lovely. I like that. Probably lovely is what it is. But this is all right. It's not bad. Yeah, as you kind of get galloping a bit later, sort of, not galloping, you don't want to gallop whiskey, but sort of sip, work it around, get it around you, kiss it, get it all there, chew it around, get your first one just a small little bit, get a chance to let the flavours get around, and then whoop a little bit more in the second one, and that's That's when you're kind of getting the slightly salty edges to it. Breathe out as well. Get it all in. Breathe out through the nose. Let the flame go around. That's nice. Yeah, it's nice, but it's kind of, it tastes young, is what it tastes. It does taste young. It don't taste like it's hardly seen wood at all. It's not them vanilla little notes you get. None of that going on, really. Little sweet notes, but they kind of taste a little bit forced in almost, that sort of thing. But it's not bad. It's not a patch on Warren Mikhailer. Cheers, everyone. Bottoms up, chin chin, and slaughter. Cheers. Now onto the good stuff. Biddly boo. Bye. And it's how you can waste it.